I'm Rashmi Mangla, back again here with my OB lecture series. This is our third lecture of organizational behavior. Before beginning, let me give a brief introduction about myself. My name is Rashmi Mangla, working as an assistant professor for the BBA department of St. Andrews Institute of Technology and Management. The subject that I take up here is organizational behavior. And the topics that we'll be covering today are historical development of organizational behavior we are already doing, wherein we had covered the classical theory in our previous class, and today we'll be studying about neoclassical theory and modern theories. Alright, so let's get started. Now, first one is neoclassical theory. Now, as you can see over here, we had studied these theories. Classical theory, we had covered in our previous lecture, wherein we covered about scientific management theory, administrative theory and bureaucratic theory. Today we'll be covering neoclassical theory, where we'll study about human relations, and modern theory, where we'll study system approach and contingency approach. Alright, so let's see in detail now. Neoclassical theory. We have only one theory within this, that is human relations theory. It also termed as Hawthorne studies, and George Elton Mayo is considered as father of this neoclassical theory. Now, it discovered that real cause of human behavior was somewhat more than physiological variables. So, in this theory, it was discovered that the main cause of human behavior, it is more than the physiological variables. It is a very wider concept. So, basically, as we studied, it is known as Hawthorne studies. So, Hawthorne effect, basically, these studies, they were conducted on workers at the Hawthorne plant of the Western Electric Company by Elton Mayo and Fritz. So, Hawthorne studies, they were a part of refocus on managerial strategy, wherein they incorporated the socio-psychological aspects of human behavior in organizations. And, basically what was done, the studies that were taken up, they originally looked into whether workers were more responsive and worked more efficiently under certain environmental conditions. When they are given good conditions, good work conditions, so do they work more efficiently and more productively or not? So these things were noticed within these studies, and the results were quite surprising. What they felt was that workers, they can improve their performance not because of improved physical conditions, but also from job satisfaction, sense of consideration. When their work is considered, when they are satisfied with the job, then also they can improve their performance, along with the fact that if they are given good working conditions, their work improves. So these were a few outcomes which were seen. Now let's see the principles that came out of this theory. The basic principles that came out were social factors affect the people. See, whatever social factors are there, like if their working conditions are changed, if they are satisfied with the job, so these factors affect the people. Then leadership is important for directing group behavior. If you want to direct a group behavior, leadership is very, very, very much important. Then friendly supervision for employees ensures good results. If you are, supervising your employees in a very friendly manner, you are not very bossy, or you're not very rude, and you try to understand their problems. So that builds a good employer-employee relationship and ensures good results. Last one, this theory attempted creation of a workforce with high morale. Within this theory, a workforce was created wherein the morale of the employees was quite high. So these were a few principles that came up with the human relations theory, wherein we mainly studied about the behavior of the humans, that according to the changes in the working environment, what changes are seen in the behavior of the employees and what changes are seen in their work also. That is what we studied within the neoclassical theory. Then we have the next theory, that is modern theory. Now in modern theory, we'll be studying two main approaches, as I told you earlier, system approach and contingency approach. Let's see the first one, system approach. A system is an interrelated part of an organization that interacts with everyone related to organization. So system is what? An interrelated part of organization. Wo part jo interrelated organization mein, and which interacts with everyone, whosoever is related to the organization. So system is an interrelated part, and it has an interaction with all the people who are there in the organization. It views the organization as a whole and as a united, purposeful system composed of interrelated parts. So organization is viewed as a whole and as a united, purposeful system that is composed of many, many different interrelated parts. So basically, you know, system approach believes in the concept that the activity of an organization affects the activity of each other part. If there is an activity, you know, which is going on in the organization, so that activity, if there is an activity in different departments of the organization, so those activities will actually hamper the work of the whole organization also. So whatever activity is being carried out in any part of the organization, that will automatically have an effect on the overall activities of the whole organization also. Now, you know, organization can achieve the results when all the departments work in coordination following the unity of direction. Organization can achieve the results when all the departments, they are following a unity of direction. If you remember, unity of direction we had studied in where? In the Fayol's principles, all right? Now, that is about system approach. The second approach within the modern theory is contingency approach. Now, you know, this theory, it is based on the premise that situations dictate managerial actions. This theory states that many, you know, situations, they are based on actions of the management. It implies that different situations require different behavioral practices for effectiveness instead of following a traditional approach. So, you know, whatever situations are there within an organization, every situation has to be handled very tactfully, and different behavioral practices are required so that every situation can be handled in an effective manner and by following a modern approach and not the usual traditional approach. All right. And you know, the strength of this approach is that it encourages analysis of situation prior to action. Whatever situation is there, we can analyze it before doing any action on it. And it stresses that there is no single way to manage effectively under all circumstances. So it, you know, it emphasizes that there is no one way. Koi ek single tarika nahi hota sare cheezon ko ek, you know, effectively handle karne ke liye. So every situation has to be dealt tactfully with different behavioral practices. Hum ek hi type ke decision se sare situations ko handle nahi kar sakte. That is what is mainly discussed in contingency approach. So that was all about the theories that we had studied. And with this, all the theories are covered. Let's see the questions based on today's concept. Explain modern theory. What are the key principles of human relations theory? Stay tuned for more upcoming lectures, students. Thank you.